Hello, what's good? Up, Sage. Let us continue this playthrough here. What do I think of it so far? I think it is very linear, and the motion controls are interesting. But it's fine.
Samus, your highest priority is to get Skytown's Aurora unit back online. It will help you find a way to reach the seed.
Help me find a way to reach the seed.
We will upload its coordinates. Proceed with caution.
Aerial repair drone. Databots. Shoot to access information. Nice. Lore. Oh, it's also indestructible. Not echoes. Holy statue appears stuck. Its arm is outstretched as if to offer something. Okay. If you switch to scanning, you can't grapple. Yeah, we'll have to see Sage about Prime Trilogy. I'm just hoping you can use Pro Controller. That would be ideal. Sky Town. I mean, I think what you're looking for, or what I would be looking for, if they're going to keep motion controls, it's got to be gyro, because gyro aiming is actually really good, but like Wiimote aiming is all right when it's cooperating. I don't like that turning is based on aiming, if that makes sense. I wish there was some way for me to, like, if I could push D-pad right or D-pad left, if Samus would turn. Having it be dependent means I have to go like this to move, you know, to spin around, which is really weird. This is the original. It's not on Trilogy. I'm just playing, like, Corruption by itself. Interesting. Panzer Dragoon Samus right there. Hey, what's up, BGW? I would just like to play Prime games with twin sticks. I think, like, right stick to aim would be awesome. Okay, what are they gonna do? Oh, they're gonna attack. Okay. Oh, they didn't put up much of a fight. Oh. Wait, they're supposed to fix that? Hold on. Oh, they're dead now. It will fail to function. Rip. I feel like I'm the bad guy here. Yeah, gyro aiming with a stick is good. What concept is Prime 4 going to take from a Zelda game? Durability of beam weapons. Nice. Oh no, I fired the beam 3 times. Now I need to get a new one. Oh, this is the launch pad. Boom. Simultaneous blast to all targets. Scatter beam. Nice. Fell out from underneath me. So we can zipline if we want to. I think we want to, because there's nothing else to do here. Yeah, we're gonna go ziplining. Steam Lord. Up there. Convenient how all of these planets have hand scanners. Playing that sound effect like there's a save point here. That's a spider ball track, isn't it? Requires a kinetic charge to activate. Bots. I don't have a high temp beam. Aimer, please. Dude, missiles in this game suck. They don't home like they're supposed to. Boom. Wow, energy tank for that. Not bad. Steam Lord defeated. Oh, it's time for motion controls. Yeah. Control systems are online but require manual activation to start the lift. Okay, so you're telling me I gotta push the button. Hold on. Everybody, hold on. This doesn't seem to go anywhere. Time for more rails. Remove the safety cap to enter and use the cannon. This is going to be one of those scatter beam things, too. Ah, yes. Repair drone. A lot of stuff to fix on this planet. Is this an ice beam door? Ah, there's my save. Game has been saved. I don't know why the pointer is really all over the place today. High temp. Well, we must be getting the high temperature beam pretty soon because everything on this planet requires it. That looks like a big boss. Administer vaccine to repair.
Chamber has been sealed off and secured by a kinetic lock. Continue exploring Skytown. There must be something in this facility that can help you open the chamber gate.
Thanks, voiceover. Sky Puffer. Boom. Gore's powered battle armor. What happened to Gore? We have a few options here. Yeah, I can go either one of these ways here. This is an interesting map. Okay, we'll go this way first. Been here before. Yo, look at all this free farm I'm getting. Them all out. 600 kills. I'm a killer. Load times. They could easily be ripped from their mounting, huh? Big rip. Dragoon. Ah, it's another rip off, huh? Let it rip. He's playing the sound effect like I'm at a save room, but I'm not. Seems very bad. It's not a very great place for an encounter. Thank you. Now what? Okay. Cutscenes explaining where to go next. Initial power. Additional power. Clamps within the floating structure. Oh, this isn't gonna work. I'm falling. Lamps within the structure. See. Any excuse to have a morph ball sequence? I heard this game was Echoes. Oh, that's the end of the morph ball sequence. I pushed Z. Where are you going, Samus? Engage manual control unit to move crane into position. That sounds like a morph ball sequence. You know what kind of morph ball sequence we haven't had yet in this game? We haven't had the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater sequence, where we're in a half pipe trying to get some big air. I'm looking forward to that one. Oh, that is not what I expected to happen. What just happened?
Our Our scans have detected a cache of Chozo technology. Perhaps something there will help you gain access to Unit 217. Here are the coordinates.
Well, it's a good thing I'm in this area. What did that do? Is this close enough that I can actually get there? Okay. Yes, this goes all the way back to the start, so I don't think I want to do that yet. That would be very bad. Lore. You know what? You're absolutely right. This is not Echoes. What are we gonna get here? The high temperature beam? Boost ball! Yo, it's the boost ball! Oh, it's a trap. I should have known. Nobody just gets a boost ball for free. Oh man, so it's the same boss I just fought. Great. Overloading the system may disable the lock. I haven't done damage to it yet. We might be dying. Oh, it's a grapple. Grapple. And it doesn't take any damage. What are you doing? I don't think going into hyper mode helped at all there. I can't believe it's making me refight the same boss I already beat. It's one of those fights where I can't do anything because Samus is busy moving her hands. I could have won on this round. Okay. Yeah. Did I win? I won. We did it. I thought it was going to make me do another round. I knocked a lot of health back for that win. Ball. We got a first try. Some old B to boost. B for boost. Oh. Well, all right then. This is the only way to go. This is back here. Okay. I know where I am. Assuming I don't want to go down here? Maybe I do. B for boost. Alright, we gotta figure out what boost is used for. Flint, you are late, but you are just in time. If that makes any sense at all. It means you are still here for not echoes. I wonder if I'm supposed to go in here. Okay. Oh, this is going to be a recurring thing. Okay. Sure what that did exactly. Oh. Okay. Sure. Key scientist in power suit technology. Energy lock is low on power and requires more to unlock. You're saying it needs a boost? I think it needs a boost. Oh yeah. Oh, look at bowling for bots. I was just gonna make a bowling joke, but it's an achievement. Nice. Strike. Achievement unlocked for bowling the bots over. That's funny. Never knew you could do that. You learned something right here on my channel. All right, we gotta figure out where the other. There was another pathway I could go. Way back early on. Where was that? There was a whole pathway. It split in two somewhere. It might have been this, all the way back here. Spire Dock? Or this? No, that's where. This is where we started. I think we want to go back this way, towards Spire Dock. Now, that being said, I can't read the map, so... Zipline Station Charlie. Get Aurora unit back online. I have no idea where I am. Does it even tell me what room I'm in? Okay, I'm here. So I need to go all the way around the circle and go out the other door. Maybe. That's definitely not it. This is it. Because this is, yeah. This is what I'm looking for. Alright. And the save point is this way. I think. Nope. It is definitely the other way. I'm gonna hope it's this. No, where's the save, though? Am I locked out of saving? Oh, am I locked myself in this room? Great. Well, I guess we're going to fight whatever this is now and hope we don't die. Okay. We'll just be leaving now. All right, we won't be leaving now. Hope this is one of the chore mini games and not a boss. It's a boss. Alright, that wasn't that bad. Uploading vaccines. Objective complete. But wait, there's more.
This turbulence is insignificant. I'll show you what I mean. Up there!
But I just wanted to save the game. Fine. Just walk away. Here's how to beat me. Yeah. No way to open the door. Weapon upgrade required. Well, that sucks. So you're telling me I have to come back. You're telling me I can't leave. I get out of here. Oh, okay. Still can't leave. Sure, no problem.
There is much to do. We have communed with AU-242 on Olympus and learned that a Leviathan impacted Elysia and began spreading corruption. We must destroy this Leviathan and stem the tide of corruption as soon as possible. We have a plan. The Gore's attack severed key communication cables, disrupting our access to Skytown's primary network. This prevents us from controlling Skytown and executing our plan to destroy the Leviathan. Gore's plasma cannon should be able to fuse together the severed cables. We must ask you to hunt him down.
Gore's plasma cannon.
Gore may have changed, Samus. Be prepared to deal with that. Good luck.
Sure. Can I leave now? I can leave now. Okay, good. Where's the save point? It's back this way, I think. No, that's not it. I'm gonna assume we want to go back to where I was, because there was stuff to do there still. Oh, it's so good to have Boost Ball again. I think I didn't go this way yet.
Ship status alert. Unknown entity approaching. Commencing hull lockdown.
What? Why did Samus uninstall Boost Ball? How does Samus frequently lose all of her abilities? I mean, it's just uncanny. Right, I guess I'm supposed to go back to my ship because it's under attack, but I also don't care. Well, let's keep going. Maintenance platform is automatically moving up toward an open duct in the wall. Rotate the gear. Okay, we have a couple options here. Press A to interact with objects. Where does this go? Evacuation pod. So you think it would, like, let me leave if I need to? Twist the Wii remote. Oh. Oh, look at this interactive minigame. Wow. Better lock picking than Skyrim. Elevator. There's a lot of elevators in this zone. Where'd this go? Cannot be unlocked until it regains connection to the network. So you're telling me I get it.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taking damage.
Hull armor taking damage. Good for it. Think I care? What are you gonna do? Game me over? Wouldn't surprise me, because you gave me over for the dumbest things, Metroid Prime 3. Whoops. I don't even know where I am now. I'm confused. There is a prize up there. Figure out how to get there. happened here? Oh, this is in the way. I thought there was another door I didn't go in, but I can't find it. Anybody else excited for E3 in a couple days? I feel like we know a lot of the stuff that's already going to be there, but at the same time, the Nintendo Direct always unleashes like 30 games at once. So I'm pretty excited for that. Yeah, I feel like this is... once again, Nintendo's E3 to lose. They can very easily win it. Yeah, we're due for some new Switch titles, really. Although, I gotta say, after watching Smash and Splash, I kind of feel like playing Splatoon 2 and Ultimate again. I do feel like I missed a door somewhere here.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taking damage.
Alright, fine. We'll go back and fix the ship. I can figure out where it is.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taking damage.
Last Switch game I played was Octopath. Octopath was okay. I don't love it. I think it did a lot of things wrong. I don't like that everybody's story was the exact same thing. And I don't like that they just sort of like threw together a finale. I need to play the Breath of the Wild DLC because supposedly it's just more shrines and stuff. Never played it. I'm gonna save here because I don't know where I'm going. I'm just going back to the start. But yeah, I feel like the Switch has been banking on the same titles for a long time now. You know, they're really dragging it. Like, even this at this year's E3, they're having another Splatoon 2 tournament. And that better mean, like, Splatoon 3 announcement or, like, more Splatoon 2 support or something, because I don't know. Like, I like Splatoon 2. It's a good game, but... You know, give us something new to be excited about. Oh yeah, Pokemon Switch. That's going to be sick. I'm actually really excited for those games. I feel like they're going to show us a lot of Mario Maker 2, and I don't really care. Especially now that they ruined the online play when they said you can't play with your friends. I actually think I'm going to cancel my Mario Maker 2 order. Because I feel like I got my fix with Mario Maker 1. Even if they added new stuff to do, like as far as level design goes, I don't know that it's enough to make me want to buy it again. I mean, it looks like a more complete version of Mario Maker 1, but I was really hoping for that online play with friends. That just seems ideal. The Nintendo phone. Hard Drive Magazine is killing it. I love the Hard Drive. Yeah, the like random versus mode is really strange. I don't know why they thought that was a good idea. This is definitely backwards because... I remember this room. Oh, this is new.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taking damage.
All right, what does this get me? Half pipe? Oh, did I call this or what? Except we haven't had a Tony Hawk sequence yet. Random only online is baffling. It's less baffling when you realize it's Nintendo. Nintendo is literally like one feature away from nailing online every time. Like Mario Kart 8. Why doesn't 200cc have its own playlist? That's literally all you needed to do, and I would still be playing that game. Like, why did you drop the ball that badly on that? You know what I mean? Like, they get so close. ...200cc was a mistake. I love 200cc. I can't even play 150 anymore after playing 200. But it... Yeah, literally everything aside from online, and they butcher online, I agree, BGW. They've been doing it for a decade or two. Like, yeah, even the GameCube, I mean. I guess we can give them a pass on that, because it was still pretty early on in, like, console online, but... Saying that Nintendo is still in the year 2000 when it comes to online is insulting to online games from 2000. That's also accurate. But yeah, I just feel like they get so close every time and they just can't get it right. You know? It's like Smash Online. What's the deal with like every match being a slideshow, you know? It's... Yeah. It's pretty awful. And then on top of that, I mean, not that $20 a year is a lot of money. Like, I don't mind paying that for Switch Online, but I would have liked to have seen that money go towards, you know, trying to improve it somehow. Or here's the other one I always like. So Splatoon 2, right? Splatoon 2 online, pretty good. It's pretty good. But why are we limited to playing two maps? Like, could you imagine buying a Call of Duty game and being told you can only play two maps? You know, tomorrow you can play two different maps, But for today, we're just going to, you know, we're just going to get you familiar with, you know, CS Office and DE Dust. You know, once you're getting tired of those, maybe tomorrow you come back, we'll have Aztec and Dust 2. Like, I don't get it. Like, that's okay, that's fair. Everybody just wants Dust 2. That's fine. That's fine. 24/7 Dust 2. That's fair. But yeah, they like make up their own problems. You know, they limit themselves. It's like all you had to do was include like one more feature. You already have a 50cc playlist. You already have 100. You know? Why did you put 150 and 200 in the same pile? Yeah, if every map is available, then new players look confused and quit immediately. Yep. Yeah, Nintendo Online is cheap when you have an 8-person family. That's true. That's fair. All right, twist the Wiimote. It just disappoints me because you know for a fact, like, if Microsoft was in charge of this, right? Like, they would be nailing the online for all of these games. Which is a weird thing to, like, give them credit for, but that's something that the Xbox in general has just always excelled at compared to everything else. Halo on PC. I am optimistic for that. That will be interesting. Although it makes me regret buying an Xbox One because that's literally the only game I was interested in playing on it. Oh, I missed this the whole time. Nice. Just sitting right there. Never played a Halo other than 3. Halo 2 is very good. The other ones are fine. Actually, you know what? Halo PC, the original, like when they ported that to PC, that was very good. Multiplayer in that was awesome. Spent many days playing that.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taking damage.
It'll be interesting to see Microsoft's conference this year because they have, I think they said they had 14 different first party games that they're going to be showing. So that'll be interesting to see what they've come up with. World premiere. I love that guy. It's the same voice every year, too. I think they just have the same clip. They recorded it like 5 years ago, and they just use it for every one of the conferences. World premiere. Exclusive. Just wanted to give me to say. You got me. I'm very gullible. Please welcome the head of Xbox, Phil Spencer. Phil Spencer comes out wearing some leather jacket and a graphic t-shirt. At Xbox, it's our duty to make Call of Duty the best game, the best experience, Call of Duty. Are these the grapple guys? I gotta grapple them. No. Just blast them. Oh no, it says it could be. Could be ripped off. Yoink. So I actually decided, I tweeted out a while ago, should I take time off work for E3? Because I haven't missed an E3 in a long time. Like, I love watching E3 for some reason, even though nowadays with, you know, YouTube and everything, we get trailers. You know, we already know Death Stranding is going to be shown, right? But we got the Death Stranding trailer already. So, I don't know. I've just always been sort of excited about E3, and I see it as sort of the gaming spectacle of the year. And maybe it's lost some of that over the years, but I decided to take time off work so I could watch the conferences. It's more fun to watch them live anyway, because then you have Twitter going crazy over everything and... I think it will be enjoyable. I don't want to be at work when the direct is going on. I want to actually, like, be able to watch the direct. Yeah, I feel the same way, Checkers. Like, I don't think I've ever been, like, in the last 5 or 10 years, been sold just by something I saw at the conferences, but they're still fun to watch. I like watching when things go colossally bad and when things go extremely well. You like to see those moments where, like, Microsoft gets hyped up about voice commands on the Xbox and there's just no reception for it. Like, no one cares. The guy that gets so excited he's up on stage and he's like, it's Peggle 2! And then, you know, the same sort of reaction. Or it's Ridge Racer. So many moments. It's great. I love the theatrics of it. I wish that Sony had a conference this year. I feel like that's pathetic. I wish Nintendo still did theirs in person. Like, directs are fine. Don't have a problem with a direct. But it's not the same. You know, when Reggie walks out on the stage and he means business. It was so much more enjoyable. Ow. Oh, that's a wipeout. Okay. I always wonder what happened if I missed those.
Ship priority status alert. Warning. Hull integrity is compromised.
Yeah, I'm working on it. Armor status is critical. But yeah, even if it's beginning to lose a little bit of its luster, I still get excited to watch E3. The one opinion that changed over the years for me, though, is that when I was younger, it was a dream of mine to go to E3. I always wanted to go. And I felt like it's like a gaming checklist thing.
Ship priority status alert.
But now I don't care. I'd rather be at home watching it.
Armor damage is critical.
I think you pay way too much money to go to E3 if you're not pressed.
Ship priority status alert. Hull armor taken damage.
And I also think it's so much easier to see everything at home than it is if you're in person. Like, even just going to the conferences, you have to kind of go all around LA. And you're not guaranteed to get seats at any of them, so... It's more fun to just watch at home now. Wait, BJW, did you get into E3? Dude, wait a minute. Hold on. We have to change the plans here. I didn't know you guys were just, like, getting into E3. I thought you got to pay, like, a bunch of money. And if he's got the hookups, I'm in. Well, that doesn't look good.
Just in time.
Oh, my. Just in time. Hey, that's my ship.
Don't you feel the power? Soon everything will be corrupted, including you.
Thanks for that, Gore. Gore. Shield repels all weapon fire. Powered by a unit on his back. We'll freeze if exposed to cold. They all have that earthquake move. Every boss in this game. Might be the easiest boss so far. Beyblade, let it rip. Hyper mode? Ow. Boom. Finally, a boss I could figure out. It was very intuitive. Shoot boss to win. Plasma beam. Fire the beam with B. Can I save in this current state? Oh, look at that. I disabled my other ones. Nice. But I can save. It's good. this is okay. Let's run through the sequence here. Lost the cap on my water. Then I go to look for it, and there's this microphone completely in the way. Not the ideal setup. We got to work on this gamer setup here. All right, let's go back to the E3 conversation for a minute, because I was enjoying that and I got distracted by boss. So, okay, reasons that I wanted to go to E3, like, it just seemed like the spectacle, right? Like, I wanted to be there in the crowd for the different announcements. Now, since with, like, Twitch, like, okay, if you think about it, like, when we were kids, or at least when I was, I don't know about everybody in the chat, but the only way we got E3 information was either reading it after the fact or watching it on, like, you know, pre-recorded G4 television shows. So you would get like bits and pieces, but you didn't necessarily get all of the information. So it felt like, being there would be such a big deal. I'd get to see it all and be a part of the spectacle. Yeah, Spike TV, there you go. Game trailers. So I just, like, I always wanted to go to E3. I thought that was going to be a very cool experience, to be there for the big announcements. And now I just feel like it's so much more fun at home. You know, I don't want to pay, I think it's $250, or maybe it was $150, but in any case, to go wait in lines, like, you might as well just go to PAX. I mean, that's the same idea, but at least PAX has, you know, other stuff. So I don't know. I'm not sure if I would want to go to E3. Maybe like 5-10 years down the road, when I have nothing else to do, go to E3. Or if people have the hookups and I can get in as press, then I'll go. But yeah, I don't know. I just feel like E3 is more enjoyable at home now. It's, you know, we can watch all the conferences as they happen. We can talk about them right when they happen. Somebody asked, I think, if I was going to be doing anything streaming for E3. I don't think I'm going to. So last year I did recap podcasts and I just had like random guests on, and we do like an hour recap after it and kind of make fun of it and whatever. I'm not sure. I feel like there are enough people that do that I don't know that. And like, would there be an audience for that? Like, would you guys want to hang out and watch the conferences here? I feel like you're just going to go watch, like, if anything, you're either just going to watch the conference itself, or you're going to watch, you know, I don't know, Trihex or somebody else that's covering E3. So, I don't know. We'll see. I'm not opposed to doing something. I think, like, you know, we could certainly do something, because I'm going to be home watching them anyway. Yeah, I kind of agree, Checkers. You know, if I was going to stream it, the way I would do it is I would just have the main conference feed up during the actual presentation, and then we'd talk about it afterwards. I don't think I would interject. Not that this is specifically my thing, but smaller restreams are cool. Okay. Interesting. Yeah, we'll think about it. I mean, like I said, I'm looking for the next thing for me to do, and I've done the recap shows last year, and they were okay. I mean, like, you know, people tuned into those. So, we'll see. I don't have anything planned at the moment, but can't hurt to do something. I'm going to be watching E3 anyway. I'll want to talk about it with people, so. Let's not. Let's not go there. Not in the mood for that one. Oh, what was the other one that you said? BJW, you want to go to GDC? Have you been to GDC? What was your opinion of that? Like, did you think it was worth going to? Ooh, look at this beam. Does this strictly replace my other beam? This is sick. I highly recommend E3 over GDC. Interesting. What about E3 did you enjoy specifically, if I might ask? Did you go to, like, the conferences as well, or were you just at the venue? Mostly venue. Oh, this is gonna completely change this world because there's so many things I can melt now. Yeah, I mean, the positive of E3 is that it's all about the games, and I feel like that's part of the appeal of something like PAX to me, is that it's sort of a game-specific event. And, you know, PAX has extra stuff too. You know, you've got, like, cosplay and, like, live tournaments and things like that. Ooh. All right. But E3 is, like, pure gaming. GDC is more industry. Sure. Yeah, that makes sense. If you were a developer. All right. So, I was just looking. I'm not saying that I'm doing this, but I was looking today on the Nintendo website at jobs. And I think I have enough experience that I could apply. They had some positions at Retro Studios. You could do Retro's in Austin, Texas. What the heck? What a place. I did not know that. Well, okay. Flood of chat people who know all about it. Nice. All of a sudden, everybody's like, duh, of course we knew that. Didn't I just buy a house in Minnesota? I did, but, you know, worst case scenario, I can always rent it out. We'll figure something out.
Fork streamer, Golden, this name is the most recent one of these.
Ken.
What's a hoe?
No.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa.
Oh, TMB, thank you for the tier one sub. Much appreciated. Yeah, I guess there are a lot of development jobs in the Austin area. I know that I think Apple has a big headquarters there. A few others. But in any case, so I was looking. We got Retro Studios. There were a couple positions that I'm more than qualified for and I could apply for if I wanted to. And then I was looking at, there's some positions in Redmond and it didn't say specifically like what, you know, division or like what company, or, you know, what is the word I'm looking for? What game developer? But there were game development positions in Redmond. So you work for Nintendo, they don't know what you do, and you don't know what you do either. That's right. Seattle Speedhouse. That's a little, it's going to be a little bit more pricey, I think. Do I want to do game dev? I don't know. I don't know, honestly. It's when I first started learning programming, that's what I wanted to do. And then it just sort of, I never, like, pursued it specifically. I was just more interested in the programming parts of it. But I'm just saying, like, if I wanted to, I'm probably experienced enough at this point that I could do it. Impossible hour. Yeah, that's the thing. You probably don't get paid very well, and then you work insane hours. Yeah, the majority of people who are in the industry are, you know, probably overworked. It's one of those things that sounds cool on paper, and then you go and do it, and it's not as... as glamorous. But I don't know, there's, you know, it's one of those things where it's like every kid's dream to work for Nintendo, etc., etc. I don't even know if it'd have to be a programming job specifically. I was just looking at jobs to see, like, what's out there. And I'm not even saying I'm, like, planning to apply. I was just curious, like, what kind of positions they had open. That's true, BJW. So that's one thing. You know, I was talking about the other night on stream how my current job, I will never feel like a sense of satisfaction or like I'm making a, you know, meaningful difference. But having your name in the credits might be pretty cool. If it's a good game. Alright, well, now that we have the heat beam, I guess we gotta go through this whole zone again. This game loves backtracking. Oh, that's a weird sound. That's a good point, Jorf. Separate hobbies from career. I think it would be fun to try it. I don't know that I want to do it for the rest of my life, but just to be able to say, like, oh man, I worked at Nintendo for a while, like, that'd be, I think that would be pretty cool. Yeah, obviously you want to do research. In any case, it wasn't to say, like, this is my plan and I want to do it. You know, I'm not saying, like, I'm all in on this idea. I was just looking because I was curious. Maybe someday. Well done, Samus.
Now that you have the plasma cannon, you must repair our cables and reestablish our link. We await your arrival.
Sell your house to DP and move to Seattle. Oh, did they put the shortcut here because they knew that they were backtracking? Boom. That didn't do anything. For real? This thing resists plasma. That's impressive. I'm impressed. Could be the voice of reason. Tell him to ignore Prime 3 and just model Prime 4 after 1 and 2. I think if you took the boss fights from 2 and put it into the world of 1, you would have the optimal combo. Two's boss fights were the highlight of the game. Interesting. Okay, so there's going to be secret stuff all over the place now. Oh, is this trauma center? Okay. Nice. Expert surgeon. That's totally how cables work. Online complete. Yeah, the spinners take a long time. And I keep screwing up the rhythm on them, too.
Thank you, Samus. We have restored our connection to Skytown's network. Now we can execute our plan to destroy the Leviathan. We must first disable the Leviathan's protective shield. Unfortunately, the generator for this shield is hidden beneath the dense clouds of Elysium, and so is impossible to reach directly. As an alternative to destroying the generator, we have calculated that a massive thermonuclear explosion would likely destroy the shield itself. This facility possesses the components to create such a device. We would like you to build this device and drop it on the Leviathan's shield. Unfortunately, the components are too large for you to lift unaided. You will need assistance to move and assemble them.
There is a Federation landing site far to the east of Skytown. You will be able to find something to help you there.
We will upload the current map data of this area to your suit. This should help you get started. Good luck, Samus.
You have downloaded the map for this area. Download complete. I want to go move my ship over here, if I can. I think there was a spot over here where I could move it. It better be. Well, we can't do that yet. Thanks for the hot tip. Only I had wall jump.
Thank you.
700 kills. Legendary. What was the point of that? Comes in from the other room, doesn't it? Yeah, it's like almost like it's inside there. Ship missile expansion. That seems like a big deal. Dang. Also seems like I'm not supposed to do this yet. Maybe. Can I get in there? I'm thinking this could be boost balled or something. Oh, there's a door here. Was I always over here? No, I think I've already been here. I feel like this can be manipulated somehow. Why would this tunnel just exist and then not do anything? Seems weird. Nice. All right. So you're telling me I need to backtrack. I don't know that I know yet, checkers. I don't think I've had to use ship missiles. Go back to the other planet, I guess. I can find my way out of here. Oh, I was gonna move my ship, though. That was the whole goal of this. Wait a second. We're not done yet. Gotta go find that. Got sidetracked. Where was that place? Where that was. Was it over this way? It was over that way. No metered parking. What do you want, man? Yeah, I'm excited for the upcoming events here. Like E3, I'm excited for, and then we got SGDQ right after. Should be good. I need to decide if I'm going to anything else this year. I would like to branch out and actually try other stuff. Wow, for Plasma Beam, that's not so effective against that guy. Kind of a weak plasma beam, if I say so myself. Yeah, I thought about going to PAX. I've never been to one. E3 is, yeah, going to start next week. Well, technically, next weekend, right? Does this work both ways? Power required. I must have missed it. I think it depends on what you consider the start of E3, because Nintendo's tournaments start on the 8th, I think. And that includes, I'm assuming it includes the Mario Maker stuff, so that'll be like new footage. I'm pretty sure that was not going to be on the 8th. And then the conferences themselves begin on the 9th. Also, it's really interesting. The people they invited for the Mario Maker Invitational are not at all who I thought they would invite. Like, I took... DP told me to make guesses on who got invited. And I took like 10 guesses and all of them were wrong. But it's also... It sounds like it's going to be a pretty quick... demonstration too. I think it's only like a half hour showcase. So they probably only have a couple levels they're going to look at or something. I would have guessed it would have been like, I don't know. Like Pooh Bear or Pi or Ryu Car or those types. Yeah, Carl maybe, but he wasn't one of them. I don't remember who, now that I'm thinking about it. I think it was like four people got invited, and one of them was the completionist. And I think, were the other two... that we know, I think we're Dragon Feeny maybe, and Yellow Killer Bee. I think. And then there was a fourth person, but I can't remember who that was. Yeah, I did commentary with her at the latest SGDQ Mario Maker. I don't know, like, in my head I was thinking, like, the people that they were going to pick to do it were going to be sort of like the people who had, like, done it at GDQ, or, you know, like the Pooh Bears and the Carls and those type of people. Which is why I was, like, guessing completely wrong every time I tried to guess. But yeah, I think, I mean, it sounds to me like, I'm not super familiar with what Feeny streams, but, you know, we did commentary on Mario Maker together, and I think she's pretty into it, so. Sounds like a good choice. Yellow Killer Bee, I don't really know if she, does she do Mario Maker stuff? I do not know. I know she's from Minnesota, though, so we're getting some MN representation. What is this? I don't remember where the dock was for the ship at all. Theory that they did not want to feature ROM hack players? I don't think that's actually a part of it at all. I think that's overthinking it. I just am curious, like, what kind of showcase it's going to be, because I would have assumed it was going to be this big, you know, like, 16 player spectacle sort of thing, and they were gonna make it very like esports or what, but it sounds like they're only inviting 4 people, so I don't know, like, how much can you do with 4 people? So it's probably gonna be a pretty short thing. But you know what really sucked was, I didn't get picked to do the commentary, so I'm peeved. I'm pissed. I'm just kidding. I do think it's funny, though. Like, this might be the only time I can say this about anything. I might be the most qualified person to do it, because I think I have the most live Mario Maker commentary experience of anybody. So I was robbed. I'm not Nintendo famous enough. Snubbed again. Like getting snubbed at the Oscars or something. No, that would be really cool to get a chance to do something like that, but I can completely understand why I was not selected, right? PowerWorks. All of a sudden, this is a new thing. Is it faster for me to just die at this point and then respawn at the save? Because I don't even know where I am. Very. I thought there was a second dock that I ran into, and it was over here somewhere. Where was that? Dock. I just saw it. Spire Dock. Yeah, that's the... Is that the one? No. No, that's what warped me over here. Where was that thing? There were like 4 pieces of it I had to break. Transit hub? No. Am I standing like right on it, or like what's... Where the heck was that? Was it that thing? Maybe it was... That's just in the background. That's not even like part of the level. I don't know. This is so weird. I don't remember. And that brings you down to some boss chamber thing. The maps in this game are very, very Prime-like, we'll put it that way. They definitely fit the series well, in that they are impossible to navigate. It's a dead end, isn't it? Everything looks the same. That's true. One thing they really did a bad job of, like, post... do I even give credit to, like, the GBA games? Or do I... I'll say post-Super Metroid is making rooms distinguishable. I guess Prime 1 and Prime 2 were better. It's also hard to read three-dimensional maps, that's true. I wish the minimap was something you could just toggle on very quickly, like zoom it up. You know, like if I do this, like look at that. Look at how long I have to wait. And then I still have to try and figure out like where in here am I, and it's just very slow. Zero Mission is vibrant. I did play Zero Mission, and I would agree with that actually. If it's not here, then where is it? Because I distinctly remember this thing. Just spending my time jumping around for no reason. If you guys know where I'm thinking of, feel free to clue me in, because I don't remember where this was. Not the Spire Dock. Construction Bay? Was it this thing? The map has a label for rooms in which you can dock. Oh, okay, so it's the ship thingy. Ah, landing site A. There we go. Thank you for that. I appreciate the way you told that to me so that I could still find it. I'm just gonna look around forever for that. I think it's this. Is it this? It's still wrong. No, that's right. It's over that way. Nightbot always stepping in to save the day. What'd I do without Nightbot? Thank you. Is Mothman the original Pikachu meme? I can see what you're going for. I'm inclined to say yes. This is still the wrong room. Oh, Mothman is not my idea. I'm not taking credit for that. I just participate. Maybe it was that door. They took Mario Maker, they took Mothman, what's next?
Samus, the security locks have been... This was surely a result of Gore's recent activities. I will unlock this area.
Yeah, you better unlock this area. Champ. I feel like we're making some tangible progress today. Now watch, when I come back to this planet, it won't let me spawn here. I'll have to start over anyway. Count as a checkpoint. Okay. Galaxy. No Ryan. Rio. Oh, it's time to guess which one was the one that I needed to actually go to. Federation outpost it is. Ivan Bogchamp. A very different Bogchamp than the Franker face one. Yeah, we'll never know how Frankerface Z got the purple PogChamp to be BogChamp. But at least we had something to type during Prime 2. Okay, there is an orange door in this room, so that's positive. Start. Doesn't mean I'm in the right spot, but... Wow. Able to freeze directly. Overloading the clamp with energy could destroy it. Changed. Interesting way to open a door. Oh. Looking to see if there's anything else. Nothing I can do yet. They're very impractical, yeah. It's a little excessive. But you know what? That's a heat door, isn't it? That's some lore. Franker Face D song, what I am most proud of contributing to. Gonna have to vote no on that one. Not that I did not enjoy it, but there are actual contributions I've made that I am more proud of. But that's pretty good, though. Kind of weird to think that I have a song on YouTube that has, I don't know, hundreds of thousands of views at this point. Who knew I was such a popular artist? Cage invulnerable to weaponry. A giant impact could shatter the bars. Okay. Giant impacts. Shoutouts to Bone Mom. You know, if I was smart, I would take that one-hit wonder on the road and just, like, that could be my career. You know, the next 30 years, I just perform that song. They invite me to TwitchCon to perform it. I get my one-time paycheck of however many thousand for appearing. PAX's Twitch Partner Party. What did it say? A giant what? A giant impact could crumble the debris. Giant impact. We have anything that can giant impact? I don't feel like we do. Get it. There's nothing to do here. This might be one of those dead ends. Man, the doors here are quite something. More to this room, too. We're not done here yet. What are you gonna do? Okay. That got me... What exactly? Like, without the spider ball, I can't do anything else here. Oh, wait. I lied. That looks breakable. Thank you. All right, we found it. Didn't go too quickly here because this is probably something. There is something down there. Going backwards. I've been here before. I feel like we missed something there.
Further analysis of the ancient reptilian ruins on Brio has revealed the unique energy spot.
I'm sure it has. Crap.
We suggest you that we will transfer the...
Get off my screen. Oh, way over there. All right, then. When you're not even in the right region. When you're in another area code. Can't go that way. Why can't I go up there? Bombs work the way that they're supposed to. No. Okay. Now what does this get me? I know I can do it. All right. We got what we wanted. Now let's get out of here. Brio doors. Okay, this did put me in this room. This is... Wait a second. This is not the room I thought it was. Apple beam. Half pipe. Made famous by Tony Hawk. Okay, well, we gotta go for the half pipe. Nice. Picked it up in transition to full body. You know what? I think I could probably just do this too, couldn't I? Is this gonna be a thing? Oh, no, maybe not. Kinda looked like I could go in there. Nothing over here? This is... another place I've already been, I think. I guess it's kind of... it's fine to, like, go back and check these areas. It doesn't hurt anything, but... that's not where I'm supposed to be going. Samus. Get out of there. Oh, you dummy. Alright, we're just gonna die in this room. I see. Power suit grapple functionality insufficient to interact with. Cool. I'll be back. There needs to be a function on the suit that calls the ship anywhere. I don't even know where the ship is now. Now I gotta check the map. How embarrassing. Nice. multiple people had the same idea. Oh, you know what? Did I ever go down here? Well, maybe. Can't see down there. Must be like a save room. Yo! The random energy tank find. Okay. That made it worth. Who knew? It pays to explore. It pays to discover. No! The lock-on targeting grappled when I wanted to babble. That is the face of a broken man. That is the face of a man who cannot find his ship. In aim mode again. I don't know where I am now. Oh, it's really close. Okay, wait. It's in the room behind me? Hangar Bay? Is that what this is? Is it this? Hey! Woohoo! Yeah, one thing that they really changed after Super Metroid was how frequently you can fire missiles. To the point where, like, I have 75 of them. There's never going to be a situation where I feel I need 75 missiles. Because I don't have the patience to fire 75 missiles. So it wanted me to go here. I don't remember. Prime 1, could you spam missiles? Oh. It's a glitch. Don't say it, it's the G word. Don't tell the G. If I work at Retro, if I end up taking that job, we go to Retro. I'm gonna leave in some speed glitches for you guys. Don't tell anybody. There's an item up there too, I remember that. Crude bolt system. The grapple points? Too low. I could get up there somehow. Oh, you know what? There's a door over here. Let's try this. Let's get up there. We're gonna solve this puzzle that I couldn't solve at the start of the game. Set it all on fire. There we go. Whoops. Oh, that was actually intended. All right. Where are we going? Ow, big one damage. Ow, no damage. This looks dangerous. Nice miss. Oh, I see. There's no way out of there. Okay. This is new stuff. Brand new content. Never before seen. Twitch.tv/GoWanden. They were so proud of themselves when they made that puzzle door. Prophecy. What is hitting me? There's nothing else here, but this is the thing I was looking for earlier to solve the puzzle. We need a way up here. This tree is in the way though, isn't it? Am I supposed to grapple if I can't jump through the tree? I don't have to. What is that thing? Nice. I missed some scans. Where am I trying to get to? It's around the corner. Investigate the unique energy spike. How are we doing on time? It's a little bit after 11. All right, let's keep going. Try to get some more content in here tonight. If you're a fan of content, and you're in the right place. What kind of content are we talking? Look, the DK rap mentions inflating one's self just like a balloon. Did you know Samus can do it too? Isn't that riveting? All right. Kind of fun to go back through the environments you're already in and just break everything. That's creepy looking. All right, who wants to bet this is a boss fight? Because I do. Oh, suddenly I can't break anything anymore. This looks like we're setting up for something. All right, I'm ready. Can I bet if I know the answer already? As long as you don't get caught. That's how it works in the gambling world. That's what the movie 21 taught me. All right, what did that do? That did nothing. Seriously, what did that do? That did nothing. I'll try that again, I guess? Fine. Ooh. Okay. spinner. I haven't seen one of those in this game yet. I don't think, anyway. Let's try it again. Boom. We solved the puzzle. Looks like we did. Did he go offline? Permanently offline. That looks interesting. Approach pedestal to initiate teleport. Sure. What could the consequences of this action be? New area discovered. Achievement unlocked. That's what I like to hear. Alright, how mean are they? They're gonna hide something in like one of these tiny pieces of ice I gotta break? Numerous fractures detected within ice sheet. High temperature shots could shatter it. I'm getting a very chill vibe from this song. For you. It's invulnerable. Guess we'll just keep falling down. It's the save point. This is the outdoors. Will this be another boss fight that's debating me? Screw attack. I thought it was an energy tank. Okay. Hope it's easier to do than Prime 2. That was quite a stream. You guys know if you were there. Now it's truly echoes. Press A, then press A, then press A repeatedly. Let's see if I can do it. Oh, we're gonna get a boss fight first. Or that will happen. Okay. Oh, I missed some lore. Now I have to go back. Oh my god, I did it first try. I'm a new me. Man, who put a sub on the line for that one? Oh, no. No. She didn't stop. She was so energetic. Okay, good stop. Oh! Got robbed. Is this the correct spot anyway? Was this where I came from? Or is this... Oh, wall jumps. Okay, yeah, yeah. This is the new area. We made it. The hand. Strong blast could activate it. It's automatic! Oh, it's not automatic. Yeah, dude, great. Dot, dot, dot. We've gone Squall from Final Fantasy VIII. Giant statue was waving hello to me. It was. It's very nice of it. If FF7 is massively successful, do you think they will take us to Abed 8? You were making a lot of assumptions in that question. Starting with FF7 remake being released. But the answer to your question is no. No, they will not. Final Fantasy VIII is dead to them, literally, because they lost the source code. By having Final Fantasy VIII installed on your own computer, you have more of the source code than they do. No, FF7 Remake will inevitably be released, but it's going to be one of those 10-year-long things where they just push it out eventually, like Kingdom Hearts 3, and then it's just like totally mediocre. All games that get stuck in development hell like that end up extremely average. As much as we want it to be successful, I think it's going to be a long shot miracle if it is. Wow, that was a long load. So that whole sequence was to get screw attack. Interesting. So that I can wall jump. There's been quite a few times in this game where I thought the game crashed or, you know, was having trouble reading the disc. Not the first time. Okay, so now the objective is to find the ship so we can save. And that was back here, so let's go this way.
Samus. Samus, are you there? We have been trying to reach you. Is everything all right?
GLaDOS won't leave me alone.
There are some important new findings. A reconnaissance probe has discovered the location of the missing flagship Valhalla. As I am sure you are aware, this vessel was attacked by pirates 5 months ago. We request that you investigate the Valhalla, but anyway, we will upload the coordinates to you.
Upload those coordinates. Ooh. A new galaxy. All right. Big Pog. Ow. Hit my ship. All right. I think this is a good point to stop. We'll explore the new territory next time. Good content. We made some good progress tonight. That was solid. Got through a couple zones there. So, thank you all for watching this weekend. Well, stop spinning. Don't make the viewers puke. Yeah, yesterday was a little rough. We didn't make very much progress, but today made up for it. We got some good progress there. So, as far as this week goes, expect more Prime 3. And then I guess we'll decide if we're going to do anything for E3, or I'll let you guys know on Twitter if I'm going to do anything for E3. If I do, I think it might be pretty tame. You know, it's not going to be like an extravaganza, but we can certainly hang out and chat about stuff. So, cool. All right, well, that's it for me for tonight. Thanks for watching, everybody. And we'll see you for more Prime 3 this week. Have a good one.